Hello, good evening, and welcome to the Business Report on News 360. My name is Pa Kwesi Asare. Let's begin with matters within the petroleum industry. And consumers are to expect between 2% and 4% reduction in fuel prices in the first pricing window of November 2018. According to projections by the Institute of Energy Security, the falling crude oil prices, finished product prices on the international market, and the city's stability against other major trading currencies will contribute to the reduction. Currently, a liter of diesel and petrol is being sold at 5 cedi 21 pesos across all major filling stations, including Total and Shell, indicating a hike from 5 cedi 7 pesos. The institute is expecting some oil marketing companies to be influenced by the price deregulation policy to effect reductions beyond the projected margin. Meanwhile, the Institute of Energy Security and CATS International have called on government to scrap the special petroleum tax on fuel to reduce a burden on the consumer. They made the suggestion ahead of the 2019 budget presentation. Well, the Ministry of Finance is expected to present the 2019 budget on November 15. My colleague Nuang Falon has the rest of the story.
Fuel prices exceeded the 5 cedi mark in the first pricing window of September. Since then, several stakeholders have called for measures to cushion Ghanaians as the prices of petroleum products keep rising.
Scrapping of the special petroleum tax. We still insist that it should be scrapped and is going to help. What happened to the price of transportation? The moment fuel prices go up, there's a temptation for these transporters to increase their prices as well. It goes to affect the economy. From that moment, goods and services also tend to go up. So in the long run, government come back to receive the pinch of this.
Coordinator at CATS International, Apia Kusie Dumako, explains removal of the SPT will lessen the impact of exchange rate vulnerabilities on consumers.
Remove the special petroleum taxes so that consumers in this country can have a sigh of relief.
Other expectations include a clear policy direction for the Tema Oil Refinery and the Bulk Oil Storage and Transportation Company, BOST.
We also heard that Tema Oil Refinery was going to be turned into a tank farm by the former Energy Minister, Boache Jakun. IES is expecting government to give a clear policy direction for Tema Oil Refinery. Are they going to revamp it? Are they going to expand it? 45,000 barrels per day is not enough to be competitive anywhere in the world.
Executive Director of the Institute of Energy Security, Pa Kwesi Anamwasechi, suggests hedging oil imports as a risk management strategy against fluctuations of crude oil prices and the exchange rate.